Hey, what's going on YouTube? So today I was just going to show y'all how to salt your own bait. It's a really simple process. Got some leftover bait shrimp that went ahead and peeled it and don't want to waste it. That it doesn't ever seem to come out of the freezer fine for doing bait. So this way we tried a little bit last year and it worked pretty good. We had really good luck with it. I actually kind of preferred using it over the good fresh stuff. It definitely stays on the hook better. It's a whole lot easier to deal with. Dang sure a heck of a lot tougher, which is the reason I think it probably worked better than the fresh stuff. I mean, them fish could pull that off super easy. So today I'm just gonna run y'all through the process. Doesn't take much in the way of materials. So get you some shrimp, we'll get some salt, and kind of show you what to do. So this is what I'm using. It's just fine stock salt. It's a 50-pound bag, get it at Tractor Supply. That'd go a long way. You probably don't need that much. You can get salt, you know, any grocery store. I'd recommend getting the non-iodized, but sea salt, anything like that. So I'm hoping we got y'all in the frame. Here's our shrimp, nice fresh stuff. So I just peeled it yesterday and put it in the refrigerator. I mean, you can do it all same day. Got a bucket, labeled it. Not that that's really super necessary. And what I like to do is just put a layer of salt down. And we're gonna just randomly drop a layer of shrimp in there. You can stir it up a little bit, kind of keep them from sticking together as bad. Do another little layer. This does use, it does take some salt to do this, but you can reuse this salt. I've used the same batch of salt last year, did this bag, what's left in this one. This is one we were using. Even kind of experimented a little bit with some little croakers and mullet. So far they're hanging in there. This bag of shrimp I actually left in my tackle box on accident. Shoot, for a good couple of months. Back there in my room, didn't even know it. It didn't start stinking or anything. You could rig these up and just stash them in your boat for that those times when stuff just ain't quite biting. Sometimes a little bit of shrimp, man, it helps. I've seen a lot of people use, you know, a bucket that's got a drain holes and drains into another bucket. You can do that. I don't think there's any real hard, fast set rules for this. The salt is going to end up pulling a bunch of the moisture out of these shrimp. I started doing this just with our little bit of leftover we had when we come back from the beach. And, well, man, this actually works pretty good. So now, I mean, just go ahead and mix some up. Our favorite time to go down there and fish on the beach is coming up. Having bait ready to roll, not having to stop and buy anything is pretty dang nice. We got them all in there. They're all covered, coated in salt. I'm gonna go ahead and just throw a layer over the top, just kind of cap them. That'll be good enough for now. Pop the lid. This doesn't really stink. It's got an interesting smell to it, but it doesn't stink. So we're gonna let these sit overnight. We'll check them tomorrow. But I'll give you a closer look at the finished product. If you know, we just kind of keep a little bucket with some water on the tailgate of the truck, rinse them off. Man, you're not having to deal with slimy shrimp. I said they're very tough. They still go on a hook easy enough. Make great baits. This is probably the oldest bag we've got. And heck, I still use those. But yeah, once you give that a day or two. So here we go. It's been 24 hours. Let's see what we got going on. So yeah, these babies are done. A lot of moisture's been taken out of them. that salt down, and the bottom's pretty wet, but the, you can see the shrimp kind of reduced in size by, oh, about half. Maybe not quite half, but that's what we're going for. What I did is got some paper towels doubled up, and I'm just gonna lay these shrimp out, try and knock off any of that wet salt, and we'll let them sit out for hour or two, and that'll kind of help them dry off, because they are still a little wet. Like I said, the salt pulls a bunch of moisture out of them, and you know, if you did it in a bucket that had some drains where the moisture would drain off, you might could skip this part. But I'll fish them all out of here, and we'll get back to when they're ready. I'll show you what I'm going to do to package them up, at least this batch. I didn't mention it earlier. I do just keep them down in the bottom of the refrigerator. With that said, no refrigeration is necessary. I've left them out. They could sit out on the tailgate in your truck out in the dang 100 degree sun, and they're still gonna be just salted shrimp. So it's pretty neat. All right, so here we go. Got them all fished out. We're gonna let them dry off a little bit. I don't know if it'll show up in this camera, but the salt's actually a little pink now. It's pretty wet. I'm gonna just leave the lid off. We're in a climate controlled room, so it'll dry out. I'll stir it up every few days. Once it's dry, I'll pop the lid back on it, stash it on the shelf, and it'll be ready for our next batch of baits. Been a couple of hours. You can see the moisture is drawn out. The salt kind of crumbles off of them now. You can't squeeze any moisture out of them. So what I'm gonna do is just fill this container here, and we'll stash them in the bottom of the refrigerator. Once I get through using these in this bag, I already have some ready for replacements. Anyway, hope this tip helps you. We've had really good luck with it. You'll see it on some upcoming videos. Thanks for watching.